Well, I want you guys to bear with me as I give you a little bit of my life story. Standing here before you guys is definitely bringing back a lot of memories and feelings. My memories of Greenwich Country Day are probably some of the best memories I have in my life. But the focus of my conversation today is to discuss some of the challenges I faced during my early days of my life and the obstacles and adversity that I had to deal with and overcome. When I was 4 years old, my family had to leave Iran due to a revolution that took place. And I ended up coming here under political asylum. And my family was forced out of Iran because of a revolution that had taken place. And in a matter of months, my family had lost almost everything. And they were given political asylum by President Reagan. And we moved to the US. And I was born in June of 1979. And shortly after I was born, my family ended up moving back to Paris, France, where my father was running a major counter-revolution. And my dad had a very important position in the previous government that was in power in Iran. My father was the commander-in-chief of the army, and at the end was the second most powerful man in the country. Now, unfortunately, in Iran, what ended up happening is a religious fundamentalist group had successfully been able to take control of the country and force the Shah out of power. So here I was living in Paris up until the age of 3-4 years old, and I could speak French and I could speak Farsi. And unfortunately, in February of 1984, a group of assassins ended up killing my father and my uncle. And that obviously is an event that has affected me throughout my life, and required my family after my dad's death to move back to the US and actually grow up in Greenwich and go to Greenwich Country Day. So when I first came to Greenwich Country Day, I could barely speak a word of English, and I had this kind of confusion and concern about, you know, this kind of foreign factor that hurt my family, and was this something that was gonna potentially happen again? And I didn't know. The beauty of this story is that it ends in a positive note. You know, obviously you now have the backstory of kind of where I was before I came to Country Day. But during my time at Country Day, what I was able to do was to show that with perseverance, anything was possible. So during my first years at Country Day, I had countless numbers of teachers and tutors who were helping me learn English. And I was able to finally overcome a lot of the setbacks that I had. And what's so special about speaking to you guys is that really during my sixth grade year is when I started to really overcome and excel. And so for me sitting here and looking at you guys with so much of your future ahead of you, my goal is to give you guys confidence whether you're doing your capstone projects or whatever you're thinking of things that you're passionate about, is to never let adversity affect what you do. My work today is focused primarily on the Middle East. And why I chose the Middle East was that I was always very intrigued by, you know, what was going on there. Obviously, you know, when I turn on the news, you hear about all these really scary stories of things that are going on and of challenges that the world is facing. And one of the things I think I want to leave upon you guys is to realize that not everything you hear in life is necessarily the truth. And if I can teach you one lesson, it's to realize that there are always multiple sides to every story, and the best way to actually find out if something is true or not is by going out yourself and trying to figure out if something is true. My job gives me the benefit of spending over 120 days a year all throughout the Middle East, and the benefit of that is I get to hear so many different perspectives on what's going on in the world. And honestly, the reason why I decided to choose my career was because I wanted to make an impact. I wanted to be able to go to the Middle East and to help bridge the gap where there is so much confusion and ideological differences, and to help people understand that we're all the same, that we all come from the same types of families, and that, you know, we can embrace each other for our differences, and whatever our religious ideologies are, it's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. So one of the good fortunes of my travels is that I came upon an organization which today is very near and dear to me by the name of Polyphony. Polyphony is a charity that's focused between Israel and Palestine, that focuses on helping bridge the divide between young Arab and Israeli children who are striving to excel in classical music. One of the guests we have today is a success story of Polyphony, and I think when you hear her story, you're going to realize just how much of a difference you can make by going out there and chasing your dream and trying to do better in this world. So if Mais can come out here, I want her to be able to introduce herself and give her story and perform.
Hello. I can't tell you how happy I am to be with you here today. Thank you for having me. My name is Mais Hriesh. I come from an Arab Palestinian Muslim family from Nazareth, which is the biggest Arab city in Israel. Since I was a little girl, my family, my parents wanted me to play a musical instrument, and especially my mom, because since she was young, she wanted to play the piano, but she never had the opportunity to do so because she grew up in a house with 8 other siblings, so this didn't seem to be possible. But when she and my dad got married, he got her a piano as a wedding gift, and she started taking lessons. When I was in the second grade, I started playing the guitar, and by then I knew that I wanted to be a musician. But back then I thought, oh, I'm gonna be a cool rock star, because I thought, oh, classical music is for all boring people. And that was because I didn't know much about classical music, since we didn't have much appreciation for classical music in Nazareth or in any of the surrounding towns. But this all changed when I was at the 8th grade, when I joined the Polyphony Conservatory to play the flute. Polyphony brings classical music education into towns and villages that otherwise wouldn't have that chance. And so I fell in love with the flute and with classical music, like by seeing this amazing positive impact on Nazareth and the Arab community. In Polyphony, we play Arab and Jewish musicians together in order to bridge the divide between both communities. And so that for me was a great experience. And but like I've never realized how many doors Polyphony would open for me. I got to play in many, many concerts in and outside of Israel. And we played in Germany, Austria, Spain, and many parts of the U.S. And in summer of 2009, they gave me a scholarship to Belvedere's summer camp in Massachusetts. And they always, always made sure that I had the best musical training. At November 2012, I got a phone call from my friend, Sarah Wilbanks, who used to work for Polyphony, telling me that the Polyphony board wants me to come to the U.S. as soon as possible to visit colleges and to meet with flute teachers, because the due date for the college applications was at the beginning of December. So a week later, I was in the U.S. But I have to admit that I was a little scared and worried that because the I wasn't sure if my musical level was good enough to be able to compete with students from U.S. colleges. And I was a little scared of disappointing the Filipino people who have always had faith in me. But to my surprise, I had really good, positive, and supportive comments from most of the teachers at MIT. And they all encouraged me to come and apply for the colleges here. And for me, it meant the world hearing this from such amazing and great musicians. But I know that also it meant that I have a lot of work to do now. So I started working on my essays for the college application on my plane ride back home. And because I had only 4 days left to submit all the applications. And when I went back home, I had a lot of schoolwork that I had to deal with, because I went to a regular school and not done, art school because we didn't have any art schools in Nazareth. But luckily, I was able to get all the work done by time. It was a miracle. And in February, I was back here in the U.S. for my final auditions. And a month later, I got an email saying that I was accepted to the colleges I had my auditions in. And then I decided to go to Bard College, where I'm planning to major in music and human rights. Being involved with Polyphony have given me opportunities that I wouldn't otherwise have had. They've given me incredible, excellent music training, and they've enlightened my mind and made me want to be this, they gave me this aspiration to be a good musician. And thanks to Polyphony, also my younger sister, Dana, is now a great pianist. And I also have six other cousins that play classical music in the Polyphony Conservatory, which is unusual in music. And also through Polyphony introduced me to many wonderful people from all cultures, which they are now my family away from home. My dream is to go back to Nazareth after I graduate from here and give back to my community with music, because I believe and I know that through the power of music, we can create a better future and a better reality.
And now I'm going to invite a third musician down to join us, and her and Mais are going to play a piece. And I hope you will think, as they're playing this piece, how music can communicate without words. So you'll actually introduce yourself to everyone.
Thank you.
Mais can come out here. I want her to be able to introduce herself and give her story.